In this video, we will talk about system testing responsibilities. Whose responsibility is it to perform system testing? You've already heard of the term independent tester. It's good to have an independent tester to perform the system testing. This is because the independent tester is not biased about the software. He will perform the testing based on his own ideas. This may allow him to find more defects than the normal tester who is part of the software development team. So there are a few things you should keep in mind. The first is the focus. Overall, the focus is on end-to-end behavior of the system as a whole. The next point is target area. So system testing will target functional as well as non-functional testing. The final point is techniques. When performing system testing, we use various techniques. We will study these in Chapter 4. A few examples would be boundary value analysis and decision table. But we will get an in-depth look in Chapter 4. So that is all from this video. Until next time, happy testing.